morning, Lakewood family. We are so excited that you are joining us today. Whether if you're here in person at Lakewood Church, you're watching online, or even if you're listening to Sirius XM, the Bible mentions, my friends, but when we are planted in the house of the Lord, we are going to flourish, and we're believing that God will continue to allow you to flourish. If it's to flourish in your relationships, flourish in your career, flourish in your health, but most importantly, to flourish within your walk with Christ. And so we're standing in agreement that this week, God will continue to just lead you and guide you and give you the desires of your heart. We have individuals that tune in each and every week to be a part of our Lakewood services. And so let us know in the chat where you're tuned in from. We will definitely love to recognize you. I mean, people are tuned in from Africa, Australia, Asia, and it's amazing to see the influence that Lakewood has, and we're continuing to bring hope to individuals all across the world, and we're so thankful to have you a part of our Lakewood ministry. But at this time, I would love to recognize individuals that are tuned in today, and we have some individuals, again, across the world. We have Jeanette all the way from Pennsylvania. Jeanette, we are so grateful that you are joining us today. We're believing that God will continue to bless you as well. We got Nam all the way from India. Wow, it's so great that you are part of our services, and thank you again. We got Denise from Michigan. Great to have you this morning, Denise. God bless you, and we're always thankful for you. We got Anna from Guatemala, and we're so grateful to have you here as well. We got Sally from the Philippines, and then we have Jerry all the way from Dubai. Jerry, we're grateful for you. What a beautiful area of the world you're in, and hopefully I can go to Dubai one of these days. And then last but not least, we got Jen from South Africa. Jen, we're continuing to pray for you, and we know that God has great things in store for you. So as you can tell, hope is rising here at Lakewood, my friends, and what an exciting service we have lined up just for you. We have the awesome homecoming weekend here at Lakewood, which many individuals from around the world came in yesterday to have a conversation and to meet Pastor Joel and Pastor Victoria and to meet some of our Lakewood staff. Please take a look at this video. What a great time. And again, we're so grateful that you had an opportunity to be here yesterday and to be a part of our services today. We look forward to staying engaged and connected with you. And thank you again for being a part of our homecoming weekend. Our Lakewood Drive is actually 2 weeks away on Sunday, April 28th. And the Gulf Coast Regional Blood Center will be here after each service. And, you know, I just want to just encourage you individuals that are donating blood. You are literally saving someone's life. And so we just want to encourage you, if you're around the area, if you're at church, they would definitely love to have you there. You can find more information or even register at lakewoodchurch.com/blood drive. And also, my friends, the information is found in the chat. That same week, on May 1st, we're going to have a special worship night. And we all know that scripture in the Bible. but praise precedes victory. And so we're hoping that you could take part. We have the awesome team from Elevation Worship. John Saul will be here. Jenna will be here. And so you don't want to miss it. It's going to be a great, great opportunity to praise and worship Christ. And we look forward for you to join us as well. Now, guys, we got something just for you fellas. Starting on Friday, May 17th, it is our Lakewood Men's Night. Pastor Joel and Pastor Nick will be here, along with a special guest, Miles McPherson, will be here. We're going to have games. We're going to also do tailgating party food. And again, it's a great way for us to fellowship, Mighty Men, and continue to chase God and believing that God will continue to guide us and give us the desires of our heart. And so if you want to know more information about how to be a part of that, you can go to the chat. You could find their information in there as well. And we look forward to, again, seeing you guys on May 17th for our Lakewood Men's Night as well. Hundreds of you have already registered to attend our Hope and Life Conference on June 26th through the 28th for the youth and young adults. And if you haven't already made plans to, come on out. It's a free event. It's going to be a star-studded event. We have individuals from Luio Giglio will be here. Robert Madu will be here. Charlotte Gamble will be here. Torn Wales, Elevation Rhythm, Lakewood Music, so many more will be here that day. And so we hope that you could come in and join us. You can register at hopeandlifeconference.com, and also you can find the information in the chat. And we hope that you can join us to be a part of an awesome conference. Our pastor has another dynamic book out entitled Speak the Blessing. Each and every week, we hear Pastor Joel making declarations. I am blessed, prosperous, redeemed, forgiven, talented. Those declarations continue to activate God to do some mighty things in our lives. And so it's great to have faith. It's great to believe. But God sometimes could be waiting for us to activate our powers through speaking what God declared. We all know the story where David was facing Goliath, but David did something in terms of activating the word that God had put on his heart. And Pastor Joel wrote an excerpt in his book, and I want to read this to you, but he says, "Dare to declare what God put in your heart. When David went out and stood before Goliath, he went out there and said, 'Today I'm going to conquer you, and today you will fall.' And David ended up defeating the giant, and you know the rest is history. David went on ahead to become king of Israel." Continue to speak the word of God, and we're believing that for you guys. So as you could tell, the Lakewood, we've got our vision boards. Continue to write on our vision boards, and we're believing that God will continue to speak in your heart. And you can also find our vision wall board and information at lakewoodchurch.com/share-your-story. If you have a prayer or you're believing for a miracle, Pastor Serena will be here midway through service. We definitely hope you could be a part of that. Well, my friends, services are about to start. We're so grateful and glad to have you a part of our ministry. God bless you and enjoy today's service.
Joel and I are so glad that you've joined us today. I believe it's going to be an amazing service. And knowing that you're out there watching encourages our heart and helps us to know that God is moving all across the earth today. So thank you for being a part of this service.
Yeah, we're so blessed to have you. Always a joy to come into your homes. People tell me they watch all over the world and stop us in different places. And we just feel blessed and honored and know today that God sees you taking the time, and we believe you're going to leave better than you came.
This is a new day. I'm calling out the mighty hero. The forces that are for you are greater than any force that's trying to stop you.
And we believe today, God, that you will do what only you can do.
He calls you a barrier breaker, a prized possession.
bless you today. Thanks so much for coming out. How many of you are ready to worship the Lord today? God's been good to us all. We feel blessed to have you here with us this morning. We just, every time I walk in, I think I feel the faith in the room. I feel victory in the room. So I know that's because of all of you guys are here. I see a lot of our people from our homecoming weekend here, right here in the front. And so welcome to you guys and all of you joining us online and listening live on Sirius XM. It's just like we're singing. It's another day that the Lord has made. And you know, it's a choice that we're making that we're going to rejoice today. We're going to be glad. And I don't think that happens because, you know, everything's perfect in our life or perfect in the world. But we come back to that place of faith knowing that, God, you're on the throne. You're in control. You've got us in the palm of your hand. And I believe when you live out of that place of faith, that's what allows God to do great things. And not only that, you can enjoy your life. Otherwise, there's always something that's stealing our joy. And we've got to be worried about this. We've got this situation. But when you know that God has you in the palm of his hand, you can do your best and then you can just rest and trust that he's going to take care of you. But welcome to you all. I want to encourage you today. You know, a lot of visitors, hey, don't be a spectator, be a participator. We're going to take the next half hour and we're going to sing songs. And, you know, you may think, well, this is different. I'm not used to this. But the main thing is, let's just take this next hour or two to say, God, I thank you for what you've done in my life. And thank you that I'm alive and thank you that I'm healthy. And It's really all about just having that grateful attitude. You know, the scripture says that every good thing comes from God, our Father above. And so just the fact that we could be here today, hey, you woke up this morning, you have breath to breathe. We have a reason that we can say, God, you're good, you're on the throne, I'm gonna have a smile and I'm gonna enjoy this day. Well, that's what allows God to do great things in your life. And I just believe for all of us that not one of us are going to leave the same way we came in today. We're going to go out of here with more joy and more faith and more victory in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, church. Your best days are still out in front of you. Amen. If someone said your best days were still out in front of you, what would you say? Amen. Yes. God is so good. You know, I want to encourage you with an invitation that Jesus gave us all in Matthew 11:28. He said, come unto me all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Wow, I don't know about you, but just hearing that God wants to give me rest is such a peaceful place to be. See, our culture teaches us that we gotta strive, we gotta struggle. Our own mind tells us that we're not good enough, we gotta keep going. But Jesus' invitation says, come to me just the way you are, and let me give you rest. And you know, when we find rest for our souls, I truly believe that's what energizes us and gives us the peace to hear from God, to be able to follow God. When we're in confusion, when we're striving and struggling, it's hard to discern the voice of God. Do we go this way? Do we go that way? What do we do, God? But God says, I want to give you rest. I want you to find rest and refreshing for your soul. So today, I want you to know that God is not a God up there saying, you need to do a little better. Why'd you do that yesterday? How are you going to handle this tomorrow? He's saying, come to me. Let me just give you some rest. And when you rest in me, you can follow me. When you learn who to come to find direction and to find rest, you know where to go from there because you're with the one that knows where you're going. Amen. He's an awesome God this morning. We love him so much. Let's enter his presence with thanksgiving in our heart. Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you that we are all gathered here, Father, to simply exalt who you are in our life. We want to thank you for everything that you've done. We want to thank you for accepting us the way we are and just loving us on the way to where we're going. Father, we thank you for your goodness and mercy and that you have so much in store for those who are looking to you. You are longing to show us your goodness, Father. So we open our heart right now and we let go of the burden. We let go of the decisions. We let go of those problems, Father. And we simply rest in you and strengthen our soul, Father, as we give you our highest praise. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. And everyone said, amen.
said it couldn't be done. This giant was just too strong. They said you don't have a chance, but there's something they don't understand. Armies rise, battles rage, they're gonna bow.
I'm gonna hear me say speaks a better word.
today. Lord, we thank you that you're on the throne, that you're in control. And Lord, like we're singing, that you're fighting our battles. And Lord, we believe that you've got us all in the palm of your hand, and that you being for us is more than the world being against us. So Lord, today we come back to a place of peace and a place of trust. Lord, we know you're in control. And Lord, we just thank you that you didn't bring us this far to leave us where we are. And Lord, as we start the new week off, we say it publicly, that you're our Lord, our God, our Savior. Lord, make us and mold us into who you want us to be. I thank you that you're going before us right now, making crooked places straight, opening right doors and closing wrong doors, that you're bringing the right people across our path. And Lord, that you'll weed out those that shouldn't be there. I thank you, Lord, that we're full of your wisdom. Lord, that we have a spirit of wisdom and discernment, that we know the right decisions to make in life, that our spiritual ears and eyes are open, sensitive, and responsive to your voice. Lord, you said you'd give us the power to obey. So Lord, I thank you that we will make decisions that move us toward our God-given destiny, and that we won't be at this same place next year as we are right now, but we are moving forward. Lord, letting go of the old, the disappointments, the mistakes, what somebody said. Lord, we leave that in the past and we get ready for the new things that you have in store. Lord, we believe you didn't bring us this far to leave us where we are. So even today, we stir up our faith, we stir up our vision, we tune out all the negativity, and Lord, we get ready for a blessed 2024. Not a get-by average year, but Lord, I think a 2024 will be a productive year, a bountiful year, a healthy year, a favor-filled year, Lord, that will move forward and see your goodness in new ways. And Father, I just thank you as we're worshiping you this morning, that every force that's tried to stop us has been broken in the name of Jesus. Depression, anxiety, sicknesses, addictions, trouble at work, at home, in our finances. Father, I thank you today is a breakthrough day, that you're doing what only you can do. Father, our eyes are upon you today, and we thank you, Lord, for all your goodness and all your mercy, and we just thank you for all that you've done. Lord, I do lift up those that are fighting battles in their health, those that are in the hospitals, couldn't make it, or even here today. Lord, I thank you that you're healing sick bodies right now and restoring health back to your people. Lord, like you did for my mother, I know you can do what medicine cannot do, that you have the final say. So I speak healing and wholeness, and Lord, that we will run and not be weary, that everything about us is getting better right now in our body. And Lord, I not just physically, but I lift up those that are in tough times and those that have gone through loss. Lord, you said you're close to the brokenhearted. And Lord, I ask that they'd feel your presence right now, that you would comfort them, that they would feel that peace that only you can give. And Lord, even though it may feel like it's the end, Lord, that they'll see that it's a new beginning, that you're still in control. Lord, you said weeping endures for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. So, Lord, I thank you for the joy that's on the way. I just speak fresh vision, fresh anointing, fresh favor for new beginnings in Jesus' name. And Lord, one more thing, Lord, we pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Lord, with all that's going on in the world, Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you are protecting your people. You are watching over them. And Lord, I just thank you that no weapon formed against your people will prosper. Lord, we bless Israel. You said when we do that, you would bless us. You said to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. So Lord, I just thank you that you're in control. Lord, we know you're bigger than any force that's trying to stop any of us. Our eyes are upon you today. Lord, you've done great things in the past, but we believe the best is still yet to come, that 2024 will be a blessed year, that we are victors and never victims, in Jesus' name. And if you receive it, can you say amen today? Amen. I receive it as well. Awesome to have you in the house of the Lord. We make a declaration of faith every service. This is what God says about us. So come on, let's say it like we mean it. Ready? I am blessed, prosperous, redeemed, forgiven, healthy, whole, talented, creative, confident, secure, disciplined, focused,
prepared, qualified, motivated, valuable, free, determined, equipped, empowered, anointed, accepted, and approved. Not average, not mediocre, I am a child of the Most High God. I will become all I was created to be. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I'm not looking at average people, not looking at mediocre people. I'm looking at children of the Most High God, handpicked. The scripture says God chose you before you could choose Him. None of us are here by accident in 2024. God chose you to be here. And I love the fact that He didn't just put you here, but He's equipped you. He's empowered you with everything you need to fulfill your destiny. It says in Psalms that God has armed you with strength for every battle. Doesn't mean you won't have some challenges, but you're not doing life on your own. The Most High God has armed you and He's breathing in your direction. And even like we were singing, I love that song, all of them, but that one that says outnumbered. But sometimes it can feel like, man, Joel, I'm outnumbered today, man. The medical report or the financial situation, or if you could see the situation in my marriage or my relationship. But can I tell you that it may feel like you're outnumbered, but really the enemy is outnumbered because the Most High God is on your side. And I always think back to that story about Elisha. He woke up one morning, his servant went outside, and there was thousands of troops that had surrounded their house, and you know they're coming after Elisha. And this young man ran back and said, "Elisha, man, we're surrounded. What are we gonna do?" And Elisha said, "You know, young man, don't be discouraged. There are more for us than there are against us." And I'm sure he said, "Elisha, man, you're getting old. This heat's getting to you out here in the desert, because there's just two of us. I saw thousands and thousands." I love what Elisha prayed. He said, "God, open his eyes and let him see." You know, he went back out and he took a look, and God let him see into the unseen realm. There's a realm we can't see with our natural eyes. He saw thousands of chariots of fire and warring angels surrounding what was surrounding them. My prayer today, God, open our eyes. Let us know that you're surrounding us with your favor, that Lord, you hold victory in store for the upright. You know, it's a great thought of this. Sometimes we do get surrounded, but something is surrounding what's surrounding you. The power of the Most High. Well, Joel, I'm surrounded by this cancer. Can I tell you, the Most High God is surrounding what's surrounding you. God has the final say. He didn't bring us this far to leave us where we are. And it all comes back to something real simple. When we believe, all things are possible. God didn't say you have to figure it out and I'll do it. You can make it work on paper. All God says, if you believe, I'll make ways where you don't see a way. I'm asking you today, 2024, let's be believers and not doubters. Let's take the limits off of God. God has greater things in your future. I believe as you do that, you're gonna see 2024 be an uncommon, unusual year where God does some things that really He just shows out in your life. I believe it in Jesus' name, amen. But we're gonna take a moment to pray. In every service, we take this next song to pray for your needs here in the auditorium. If you would like prayer, anyone is welcome to come down to the front of your section, all over the building, and we'll take a moment to pray. The rest of you are welcome to be seated if you'd like. But our beautiful online family, listening live on Sirius XM, my friend Serena is there to pray for you as well. But thank you so much for being with us today.
Well, good morning, Lakewood family. It's such an honor to be able to pray for your needs. You know, I love what the scripture says. It says where two or three are gathered, that He is here in our midst. And I know that there's more than two or three that are gathered right now. So whether you're listening via Sirius XM or tuned in right now, watching online, I just want to say thank you for the honor to pray for your needs. You know, God knows every single one of your needs before you even type them in the chat. He knows what they are. But I want to invite you to, even right now, just let us know how we can be praying for you. Our team is praying for you, and we're actually going to pray for some of your needs as well. But I just want to remind you of something. It's a verse that I was reading this morning as I was thinking about all the different prayers that are out there, individuals that are struggling happening. People are going through real situations. And I was reminded of this verse out of Hebrews 6:19, and it says that we have this hope as an anchor for our soul, firm and secure. And I began to think about that, just that word, an anchor. You know, I started to think about a boat. And many times we're on this boat of life, and there's so many things that come against us, the waves of life, the storms of life, different things that try to knock us off the boat. But we have this one thing as believers, and that is hope, the hope of Jesus. And as we throw that anchor down, what it does is it secures us where we won't get knocked off. It doesn't mean it doesn't get bumpy, but it does mean that we're firm and we are secure in Him. And so today I just want to remind you, as you bring your prayer requests forward, as you are petitioning to God, know that He hears you. You know, when you pray, God hears your every prayer request. And so we're actually going to start with some praise reports, because I think it's important for us to know that God can turn things around, amen, in your situation. And some of these praise reports were, at one point, they were prayer requests. And so I hope that this encourages you as you hear some of the things that God has already been doing within our family here. So we've got Tamara, or Tamra. She says she received the job that she prayed and she fasted for. Come on, we're so excited for you, and we're so happy for you that God showed Himself in that area of your life as you were praying for that. How about this? Patricia said that her son accepted Jesus and her son is now going to church. I know that that is a beautiful prayer answer, especially as a mother, to know that your children are being planted in the house of the Lord. And so we're celebrating with you, Patricia, and we're so grateful to be able to partner with you in prayer. And so now we've also received many other prayer requests, and I'm going to share some of them with you. I know many of you, maybe I'm not going to read your specific one, but can I encourage you with this, that God already knows, like I said, He knows what you have in your heart. And so let me read some of these out to you. Erica, I know, has been just suffering with grief as you recently lost your cousin. And so I just pray that you sense the Lord near to you. Linda, you're praying for peace as you navigate the death of your husband. And so I pray what Scripture says. It says that the Lord is near to the brokenhearted, that He would comfort you in ways that man's words cannot, but the Spirit of God can. And so I pray that you sense the Holy Spirit near to you, Linda. Many of you are believing for healing in your body. For Anne, you're praying to recover well from a hip replacement surgery. And so we just pray that you'd be able to walk and be fully functional again, and that the Lord's going to just be with every bone and ligament in that recovery process for you. And Will, you're praying to have total recovery from a stroke. We're praying the same for you, mind and body, soul, that you would be in alignment with God's word. I know many of you have friends or family members that are praying for those who have cancer. Oliver, we're praying for your brother-in-law who's battling kidney cancer. And May, who's battling liver cancer. I just pray right now in the name of Jesus, first and foremost, let His will be done over your life. But that the doctors, the nurses would have wisdom in navigating your care, and that you would have a peace that passes all understanding, Oliver and May, in this situation, especially regarding cancer, and that by the stripes that Jesus bore, you are healed. So I'm going to take some time to pray for all of our requests right now. Would you join your faith with mine? Father, I thank you so much for every prayer request that has been brought forth, and even those that I have not yet read out loud. Those that are being typed, those are in the secret petitions of your people's heart. And so, Father, I thank you that you see them. You know them. You're not a stranger to their requests, God. And I just pray right now that you would give them strength, a strength that would encourage them in the times when they feel defeated, when they feel alone. Lord, I thank you that you're a God that says you'll never leave us or forsake us. You are with them, Father, and you're anchoring them, Father. Lord, I thank you that just like David said, God, that I cried out to the Lord for help and you helped me. So Father, be their helper, be their redeemer. Father, for those who need provision, for those who need peace, Lord, you know every single need. Father, your word says you know it before we speak it. So God, would you meet them in their time of need, Father. Encourage their hearts, God. Remind them that though they may walk through the valley of the shadow of death, they will fear no evil, for your rod and staff, you will protect them, you'll guide them, you will comfort them. God, you're the great and good shepherd, Father. Lead them to the still waters, Father, in every area of their life, Jesus. Encourage them now, Father. Thank you for the friends and the community that you're bringing around them. Thank you that their faith is being stirred up, Lord. And I thank you that they too will be able to sing in advance the victory that precedes what they're facing, Lord. We receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, do you believe it as well? We love you so much, church family. What an honor to pray for you. God bless you.
At the beginning of the year, Pastor Joel invited us and encouraged us and stirred our faith to get a vision for our lives, to align ourselves with the promises of God regarding a certain area of our lives. And he just didn't tell us to think about it. He referred to Habakkuk 2:2, which says to write the vision down and to make it clear so you can see it on the run. So we did that as a church. In fact, we put vision walls all over the facility. We put a virtual vision wall online and allowed all of us to really stir our faith and write something down, to start a business, to see God restore our marriage, believing for healing in a certain area of our lives, to see God restore, to see God open doors. I don't know what it is that you've believed for and what you wrote down, but here's the good news. We're 4 months in and we've already seen God do miracles in so many people's lives. It's been phenomenal. In fact, we have some of these stories that we want to tell. And Pastor Jeremy is in our lobbies right now, and he's going to start with one of these powerful stories. Let's go to Jeremy.
Hey, thanks, Pastor Nick. We are here at one of our vision walls with Leslie and Nikki, and God is already doing incredible things in their lives in 2024. And Leslie, I want to ask you, what's been happening for you so far?
Yeah, so I've been at school since 2016. I did a bachelor's in biblical studies, and in 2020, I started a master's in theology, and I'll be finishing that this May. But halfway through my master's, I felt this pull to study at Oxford, which at the time I was like, this is crazy, Leslie. Like, people plan their whole lives to go to Oxford. You don't just wake up and say, oh, I have a dream to go to Oxford. But I think about what Pastor says when it comes to the bigness of our dreams. He says, if it doesn't scare you, it's not big enough. And this scared me. Like, it was the scariest thing I've ever done. But this past December, I submitted my application. I wrote it on the wall that I was going to go to Oxford. And after 2 months of agonizing waiting, I got the email that said, congratulations, you've been accepted to study at Oxford.
Incredible, amazing story. And it shows the faithfulness of God. Nikki, what about you? What's happening for you right now?
When I saw the vision wall, I wrote to God to help me move forward in my destiny. I currently work as a registered nurse, and a few years ago, I received my master's degree in business administration. But I felt the Lord tugging on my heart to get into the field of mental health. So I did some research, and I learned that 54 million Americans are suffering with mental illness. And 54% of those Americans did not receive any cure last year. So I applied into Yale University's Master of Science in Nursing program to become a psychiatric and mental health nurse practitioner, and I got in. I was entered in with 16 other candidates, and Yale awarded me a $15,000 academic scholarship. To say that I was elated is putting it mildly. I've wanted to go to Yale since I was a child, and when it didn't happen for me at 18 years old, I figured my dreams were over. Fast forward 18 years later, and look what the Lord has done.
God is so good. Thank you for sharing, and we are celebrating with both of you. And listen, if God will do it for Leslie and for Nikki, He'll do it for you as well.
Hey, Lakewood family, I'm actually standing right outside of another vision wall here at the church with my friend Joe. Joe, God has done so many amazing things already at the start of this year. Would you share a little bit about what He's showed you?
Yeah, for sure. You know, at the beginning of the year, Pastor challenged us to believe big, write the vision, make it clear. He gave us these vision walls to where we can go and write. And I immediately knew that was something that had been on my heart for a long time. And I knew that what I was going to write on that wall. I think the only thing that kept coming to mind were the challenges or what was going to limit me. A lot of things needed to line up in order for me to achieve getting to that place. And for me, that was purchasing a home. I knew I was going to be a first-time home buyer. I also knew things like, you know, my parents are immigrants, and knowing that all the challenges I'd seen them face, seeing family members in our community, things like that, that I knew seemed almost like an impossible goal. It was still something that was stirring in my heart. And after writing it in the wall, I knew I was believing that it was gonna happen this year. And it's awesome that I get to stand here today and say, as of 2 weeks ago, I'm officially a homeowner. God exceeded my expectations to the as smallest detail in the house. Everything that I was looking for is there, and now I'm just dreaming big about what God's going to continue to do there with my family, with my friends, with my loved ones, you know, and I'm just so grateful.
Oh, well, we're so happy for you, and we celebrate with you. Congratulations. And Lakewood family, wouldn't you know this as well for yourself, that if God can do that for Joe and be in all of the details of his life, He can absolutely do it for you too. Amen.
Well, hey, Lakewood family, I'm here with Gisela, and we are talking about her story that she wrote on the vision wall and that she's already seen God bring to pass. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, Devante. In January, when Pastor Joel said, write your vision down on the wall and make it plain, I remember God put my mom and our relationship in my heart, so I wrote it down. I wanted healing and for us, our relationship to be restored, and God has already moved. On Holy Week, y'all, Easter week, I decided to do a 5-day fast, and God put her on my heart again. And I said, Lord, if you would just restore our relationship, because it's not where it should be. I hadn't talked to my mom in months. And He did that Monday, the first day of my fast. My mother texted me that night a message that said, I carried you in my womb for 9 months. I watched you sleep as a baby, and I would do it all over again. I love you, mija, in Spanish. And when I read that, I just remember it was like if God was pouring fresh oil over me. I knew that that was a breakthrough. That was a miracle that he had promised me. And it was a breakthrough in both of our hearts. It was healing. And if he could do it for my mom and I know he can do it for y'all. So don't stop believing, y'all. Write the vision and make it plain, and he will come through, for he is the God of miracles.
Wow, that is incredible. Listen, we're celebrating God with you, and we're believing that God can do even more in your life.
Wow, can we celebrate what God is already doing in people's lives? Listen, like Pastor Serena said, if God did it for them, God can do it for you. You know, the reality is, though, we're 4 months in, and chances are some obstacles have hit that may tempt you to give up on believing for God to fulfill the promise in your life. Obstacles can come, mountains can be in front of you right now, but what we wanna do just for this moment in this service, whether you're here or you're watching online, is to encourage you to, yes, give your circumstances a glance, but give Jesus and his promises your stare. Lock in on what he's promised you. It's easy to give up. It's easy to allow circumstances and even people to talk you out of what God put in your heart. But we not only pray for these declarations or pray for these visions throughout the year and throughout the week, but today we want to speak faith over you concerning those things. Can we do that? Is that okay? If it's not too uncomfortable, could you just stand to your feet right where you're at? And we want to bless you. We want to stir your faith. Because it's one thing to have asking faith when God deposits something in your spirit, but it's a whole nother thing to have staying faith, to stay and to hold on and to believe for that business, to believe for that healing, to hold on when naysayers say it's not gonna happen, when obstacles try to talk you out of it. And so I just wanna stir your faith in this moment, and our team's gonna come and we're gonna pray some faith declarations over you concerning your finances, concerning your body, concerning your family. And I just want you to get in agreement with God's word and what they're gonna speak over your life. Can we do that? God is the author and he's the finisher of your story. The Bible says he watches over his word and he is anxious to perform it. Do you believe we serve a good God who is anxious to perform his word? Come on, let's stir our faith and let's receive these faith declarations with passion.
Amen, amen. I want to speak God's word over you concerning healing in your body and in your strength area. And I just want you to open up your heart and receive healing today, because I believe that the healing anointing is present to bring healing into your body. I speak what the word of God says in Exodus 23, that because you serve God, that he will bless your bread and water, and he will remove sickness from the midst of you, and the number of your days you will fulfill. And I believe that none will be barren or miscarry in the land, exactly what God's word says. I speak over you that God is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord, your healer. And even right now, his healing anointing is present. It is moving in our midst to make you whole, to free you from pain, to free you from disease in the name of Jesus, to free you from anxiety and depression, and that by the stripes you are healed. You are strong and healthy. See yourself that way. God is renewing your strength, and you are going to be strong, your strength like the eagles, and you will run and not be weary. You will walk and you will not faint. I declare that you will live a long, healthy, strong life. You will do all that God has called you to do because of the name of Jesus Christ. If you receive that, say amen.
I declare uncommon favor over your career and over your finances. You may have witnessed a disappointment, but God is about to bring an unpointed opportunity to come your way. Where there were setbacks, delays, frustration, lack, God is bringing you into a new land, Lakewood, which you will lack no more. I declare double for your trouble. Amen to that one. I speak blessings over your finances and in your career, that you will no longer dwell unduly all the days of your life, because God will keep you busy with the joys of your heart. I speak blessings that you are the head and not the tail. You are the lender and not the borrower. Our God is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider, and he shall supply all of our needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. Church, if you agree, can we say amen?
Lakewood Church family, the Gospel of John in chapter 8, 36 says, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So I declare today that you have freedom in every area of your life. God has set you free from addictions. He set you free from anxiety, depression, suicidal thoughts, and every debilitating scheme of the enemy. I declare that you have the mind of Christ. I thank God that those generational curses and strongholds have been broken in the name of Jesus. These issues may be in your family line, but I declare they're not in your bloodline. You have been bought with the precious blood of Jesus. I declare that every chain that has held you back is broken. I release peace. I release purpose. I release power in your lives in the name of Jesus. Lakewood Church family, the enemy wants us to give up. He wants us to give in, but I declare that no weapon formed against us will prosper. We are strong in the Lord and the power of his might. I declare that every vision, every dream will come to pass. God is going to do it. Not only will he do it, but he'll do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we could ever ask, think, or even imagine. If you believe and receive it, shout, I'm free. Amen.
Amen. I am free. Today we're coming in agreement with heaven. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. We are in agreement with heaven that God created family, and he first chose us to be in his family, and then he graciously gave us the gift of family. So I declare and decree that our families are blessed. I declare and decree not one of them is lost. They are saved by the power of Jesus' name. We call them in from the north, the south, the east, and the west. We declare that God's arm is not too short to bring them in. I thank you, Father, that our families are united, that they are full of wisdom, Father. I thank you, God, that our families see each other as the best. They see the best in each other. God, that we are families that you counsel and give great wisdom to. Father, I thank you that we will follow you all the days of our life, and that you will, Father, do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask, think, or imagine. Now, Father, I thank you that our children are set apart. They are godly to you, Father. They may be of this world, but they are not in this world. Father, you have them marked with the mark of the Holy Spirit, and we declare and decree that they will fulfill every assignment that you call them to, that they will be mighty in the land. And Father, our legacy will continue from generation to generation, that Father, our children's children will be blessed and mighty in the land. Father, we thank you that we are kind people, that Father, we reflect your kindness and your goodness onto others, that our families are kind not only to one another, but to other families. That Father, we see hurting people, and Father, we do something about it. I thank you, Father, that our families walk this earth as mighty army in the Lord Jesus Christ, that we are soldiers for you. And Father, I thank you, just like Barbara prayed, no weapon formed against our family shall prosper, and every tongue raised in judgment, every bully, every critic, every naysayer, you will show to be in the wrong in Jesus' name. We thank you for it. Father, we stand surrendered to you, wanting your teaching, wanting your wisdom, wanting your counsel. Father, give us the power to obey you. We will do what we can do, but Father, we thank you. You will do what only you can do. In Jesus' name, and everyone says, amen.
Believe what God promised you, He's going to bring to pass in 2024. Thanks so much for being with us today. We love you guys, and we'll take a moment to worship the Lord with our tithes and our offerings. We want to thank you for your generosity and your donations. Together, we're impacting people with hope and the love of Christ all over the world. Proverbs 18 says, "When you give, it can open doors." That's what we're believing for you, among other things, that in 2024, you're going to see God open some doors that you couldn't open on your own. I think about how now we're standing in the former Compact Center. Never dreamed we would be here. But that's what happens when you're faithful, when you honor God with your life, with your decisions, and of course with your funds as well. And that's what you guys do every week. So get that down in your spirit. God can open doors that no person can shut in your business, in your finances, in every good area for your children, for the schools they need to go to. But just know that we serve a God who controls the doors. And I believe because you're a giver, you're going to see some supernatural doors open in 2024.
Greetings, Lakewood family. I greet you from the northwestern province of Zambia, where I'm working at Makingi Mission Hospital for almost 4 months. We are so excited that you took the time to come to this special homecoming weekend. We want you to know that we love you. We pray for you each and every day. And I wanted to personally say thanks for your generosity, for being the hands and feet of Jesus all around the world, like we're providing care for people right here in Zambia, and also for getting the hope of the gospel of Jesus to all people all around the world. So thank you. We love you. Enjoy the weekend. Thanks again for coming.
Hi, everyone at Lakewood Church. David Friend here, surgical doc at Makingi Hospital, Zambia. Hey, thanks so much for sending over Dr. Paul Osteen. He's an absolute blessing. Together we get through a ton of work together. We save him up a bunch of difficult cases. It also gives me a chance for me to have a bit of a breakaway from here with my wife and family. It's otherwise difficult to get away. The relationship goes back quite some years, 12 I think it is. We're very grateful for all the support that you give through your whole church there, with supplies, renovating hospital wards, and even building some accommodation there. There's been an absolute ton of the stuff over the years without which we can't manage. So thank you very much. God bless.
The scripture says, "Whoever is kind to the poor lends to the Lord, and He will reward them for what they've done." People are better off because of you. Your kindness is moving the heart of God, not only towards others, but towards you and your family. See, He owns it all, and He knows how to bless your life. So today, your giving doesn't go unnoticed by God. He rewards your passion to help others. And we want to thank you that you're part of this ministry. And because you're part of this ministry, we are able to spread generosity all over the world. You see, we couldn't do this without you. So thank you so much.
We do love you. Let me just speak a blessing. Lord, thank you for all of our generous givers. Lord, we just declare what you promised, that, Lord, that you will open doors, that you will refresh them, that you will just do what they can't do. Lord, we know we're connected to a supply line that will never run dry. So, Lord, I just speak creativity and ideas. And, Lord, let contracts and businesses, the right people, find them. Lord, so that we can be a bigger blessing. Lord, you've done great things in the past, but we believe the best is still yet to come. Lord, I speak your abundance, your goodness, and your mercy over all of our faithful members of Lakewood. In Jesus' name, God bless you today as you give.
Here are some ways you can give. Scan the QR code using your smartphone. Text Give Hope to 77977. Go online to lakewoodchurch.com/give. Or call us toll free at 888-567-JOEL. Your giving is changing lives in our city and all over the world.
This may be a song that the captives can't yet sing, but if we sing long enough, they might join in with us. And this may be a dance that's too heavy for those chains, but if we dance long enough, the prisons will open up. May be a shout that those fragile lungs can't bear, but if we shout long enough, oh, the walls might finally fall. They may need some help to lift their hands up in the air, but we know that freedom's coming, so we're singing all the more. We're singing, oh, 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 the redeemed now have a song. We'll sing it all day long till the rest come running home. Prayer to pray out loud, but we'll just send those orphans home. We've been waiting all day long. Ringing the roll is ready, we can see them coming now. Just like the prodigals, we're gonna meet them in the road. We're singing, oh, the redeemed now have a song. We're singing all day long till the rest come running home. Oh, all the broken. Shout it out forever. Can't wait till you make it here. Sing it out. Say, oh, 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 oh. Strongholds start to break at the sound of our voices, at the sound of our praise. Out of our way, can't you see us dancing? There's no room for you to stay. No, no, no. Strongholds start to break at the sound of our voices,
at the sound of our praise.
And mountains get out of our way. Can't you see us dancing? There's no room for you to stay. We're singing, oh, the redeemed now have a song. You belong here, welcome home. He can't leave you where he found you. Welcome home. Found you. Welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home. If you're tired and you're broken, welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home. Say, don't get weary in well doing, for in due season.
Come on, let's all stand together one last time if you don't mind. Welcome home, everybody. Glad to have you in the house of the Lord today. We have a bunch of our homecoming weekend friends here with us right down front. We welcome all of you guys. And so many people joined us from all over the world. And we're just honored to have you with us in person, just all of the regulars as well. And just any visitor, anybody, we're just blessed to have you in the house of the Lord. You know this, but your new week goes better when you put God first place just by simply being here. And sometimes, you know, people say, you know, you're going to church, man, you could be sleeping, you could be doing something else, you could be goofing off, but they don't realize there is a blessing on your life when you put God first place and get into a community of faith. And we're honored to have you here. I'd love to meet you after the service. If you're visiting, I'll be in the bookstore lobby back there, but be my joy to shake your hand. But thanks for coming out. Guys, I got a new book out. I put out two a year, and this one's called Speak the Blessing, Send Your Words in the Direction You Want Your Life to Go. And so I think it'll be a blessing too. If you want to pick up a copy, Johnny, I'll give you that. Thank you, my friend. But blessed to have you all here. I feel blessed just being here and seeing all the testimonies on the vision wall. Man, I'm believing that everything God's put in your heart is going to come to pass. And I'm going to believe for it this year, but even if it's not, it's still going to come to pass. I love that young lady. 18 years later, she got into Yale. Come on, don't give up. What God started, He's going to finish in your life. Man, let's keep believing. But I don't think there's anything wrong with putting a demand on your faith and saying, God, I'm believing for it in 2024. Now, if it doesn't happen, Joel, I don't know what. No, God, I think 2025 is my year. You just keep believing, but nothing wrong. I mean, that lady walked by the edge of Jesus' robe and she said, I'm going to get healed right now. You know what? It happened for her. Let's be believers and not doubters. But anyway, awesome to have you here. Guys, I'm going to ask you, when you see yourself on the big screen, give our TV audience a great big Lakewood welcome. God bless you. It's great to be with you today. And I hope you'll stay connected with us during the week through our daily podcast, our YouTube channel, social media. And you can come visit us in person. We'd love to have you be a part of one of our services. I'd like to start with something funny. And I heard about this couple that had been married for 60 years and never had an argument, never had a crossword. And they were at a church function and someone asked them the secret of their success. And the man told how he always treated his wife with respect and how he took her on trips around the world. He said, in fact, for our 25th wedding anniversary, I took her to Beijing, China. Everyone politely applauded. Someone asked, what'd you do for your 50th anniversary? He said, I went back and picked her up. All right, y'all, say it like you mean it. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I will be taught the word of God. I boldly confess, my mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will never be the same. I'm about to receive the incorruptible, indestructible,
ever-living seed of the Word of God. I'll never be the same. Never, never, never. I'll never be the same in Jesus' name. God bless you. If you'd like to open your Bibles to Mark chapter 6, you're welcome to. Mark chapter 6. And don't forget this afternoon at 2 o'clock, the whole service, but it's all in Spanish. It's an amazing Spanish team we have here. And Monday night, the Bible study's online. Wednesday night's online. Wednesday night, our junior high and our high school students meet out on the fourth floor. Awesome people. And Thursday night, our college students meet, and they're awesome people too. I was with them Thursday. They're an awesome group, but a lot of great things here at Lakewood. But again, honored to have you today. I want to talk to you today about trusting God's ways. We're not going to understand everything that happens in life. There will be detours, delays, and even dead ends, and times where it looks like we're stuck. And it's easy to get discouraged when our plans don't work out, and frustrated when a door closes, or upset over that person that did us wrong. It's like we went one step forward, then two steps backwards. But God doesn't always take us in a straight line. The scripture says everything serves His plan. Not just the good breaks, times you're promoted and see in favor, but even the closed doors, the person that walked away, the promotion you didn't get. Doesn't make sense to us, but God has a master plan. He can see things that we can't see. Sometimes He'll take you backwards so He can move you forward. Or He'll close a door to force us to change. We were comfortable where we were. We were satisfied, but God wasn't satisfied. He has something greater, something that we've never imagined. He uses trouble as transportation. We don't like it. Feels like a setback. The truth is, it's a setup. The trouble is not there to stop you, it's there to propel you. On the other side of that challenge is a new level of your destiny. The question is, will you trust Him in the trouble? Will you stay in peace when things are happening you don't understand? You worked hard, but you didn't get the promotion. You were good to that person, but they walked away. It's tempting to get bitter, complain. God, where were you? This isn't fair. Well, the right attitude is, God, I don't like it, but I trust you. I know you're in control. You wouldn't have allowed this storm if you weren't going to use it to my advantage. So I'm going to stay in faith. I'm going to keep a good attitude, knowing that something greater is coming. Mark chapter 6, Jesus had been teaching the people, and it was late in the day, and He told His disciples to get them something to eat. Well, they were in this remote area. There weren't any grocery stores, and even if there were, they didn't have the funds to feed thousands of people. He said, Jesus, that's impossible. We can't feed everyone. He asked them what they had, and they came back and said all we could find were 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Jesus prayed over it and multiplied. They fed the first group of 50, then the second group, and on. After 5,000 men, plus the women and children, all had plenty to eat, they gathered up 12 baskets full left over. Disciples couldn't believe it. They were so excited. They'd just seen this amazing miracle. I can see them giving high fives, hugging each other. There was all this joy and victory. But while they were still celebrating, Jesus came over and said, I want you to get in the boat, leave here, and go across the lake to Bethsaida. I can imagine them thinking, we don't want to leave. This is a place of favor and blessing. We've just seen you perform a great miracle. But the scripture says immediately after they gathered the 12 baskets, Jesus made the disciples get in the boat and head toward Bethsaida. One translation says He constrained them to get in the boat. That implies they didn't want to. They wanted to stay in that place of blessing, but Jesus forced them to leave. He went up to the mountains to pray, and that night, as the disciples were traveling across the Sea of Galilee, there was a great storm, winds and waves, so strong. Verse 48 says they were in serious trouble. And some of them were experienced fishermen. They knew how to navigate on the sea. They had dealt with storms, but this situation was very dangerous. They didn't know if they were going to make it through. And what's significant is Jesus sent them into this storm. He knew there was going to be trouble. He knew they'd have to deal with fear, uncertainty, and doubt. But he wouldn't have sent them if he didn't know they were going to make it. Sometimes God will take you out of a comfortable situation, out of a place of blessing, where you're seeing favor, and he'll force you into your boat, so to speak. Doesn't make sense. You know God's ordering your steps. You've seen his blessing. But now the winds, the waves. God, I never thought I'd be dealing with this trouble, this medical issue, this child that's off course. You find yourself in a storm. Can I encourage you? God wouldn't have allowed the storm if you weren't going to make it to the other side. If that storm was going to stop your purpose, he would have never forced you to get in the boat. That trouble was going to take you out. He would have never had you leave that place of blessing. The reason God sent you across the lake is because he has greater things in your future. Yes, you saw a miracle like the feeding of the 5,000. God's been good to you. He's provided, he protected, he's made ways. You could be satisfied, but you haven't seen anything yet. God loves you too much to let you miss the fullness of what he has in store. And the disciples were out there in the middle of the storm, trying to keep the boat afloat. Here a few hours earlier, they were celebrating a great victory, having the time of their lives. Now they were fighting for their lives. You can hear them saying, what was Jesus thinking? Why did he tell us to get in the boat and cross the lake? He knew there was going to be a storm. They were confused and frustrated. But you're not going to understand everything God does. The scripture says his ways are not our ways. This is what faith is all about. Trusting when it doesn't make sense. Trusting when God takes you out of a blessed place and you come into a storm that looks like it's going to defeat you. As the disciples were out there struggling to survive, hour after hour went by, worried, afraid, how are we going to make it? 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came walking on the water about to pass them by. They thought he was a ghost. They screamed in terror. He said, don't be afraid. I am here. It's going to be all right. You may be in a storm today. Things have come against you in your health, finances, maybe a relationship. You could live worried, upset. No, God is saying, it's going to be all right. I'm right there with you in that storm. I wouldn't have let you get in it if you weren't going to make it through. Now be still and know that he is God. He has not failed you in the past. He's not going to start now. When you're in peace, that's a place of power. When you trust in the trouble, you're going to feel a strength and a resilience to outlast the opposition, to overcome what's trying to stop you. Jesus walked over and got in the boat with the disciples. It's interesting that he didn't stop this storm. He didn't speak to the winds and the waves like he did another time. He didn't say, peace be still and everything calm down. This storm had to run its course. The disciples were headed toward Bethsaida, but the winds were so strong, it blew them to another city. Verse 53 says, when they arrived in Gennesaret on the other side of the lake, it wasn't a mistake that the winds blew them somewhere else. Bethsaida was called a desert place. It was barren land that wasn't desirable, wasn't fertile. But the storm blew them to Gennesaret. It was called a garden of abundance. It was a flourishing place, a paradise, the most beautiful area in Galilee. When they arrived, people, of course, recognized Jesus, and they began to bring the sick to him from all over the villages and surrounding cities. They laid them on the sidewalks and in the marketplace. Jesus went through and healed them all. Even when Jesus couldn't get to them, they would come by and reach out and touch the fringe of his robe. They would be healed. The disciples were disappointed they had to leave the place where they saw Jesus multiply the food. They saw that great miracle. They didn't realize the reason Jesus forced them into the boat, had them cross the lake and even go through a storm, was so they could come to the land of miracles. Not just one blessing, but an abundance of blessings. They thought they were going to Bethsaida, a barren place. But notice what the storm did. It blew them to a place of abundance. If the storm is not stopping in your life, then it hasn't fulfilled its purpose. You have to trust that God is in control, that He has your best interest at heart, and that those winds are not going to blow you to Bethsaida, to a barren place. They're going to blow you to Gennesaret, an abundant place. The storm is a setup. The closed door, the delay, the person that walked away, it's moving you into something greater. Now the enemy will whisper, no, man, you were blessed, but look at you now. You got forced into this storm. You're headed to a barren place, defeated, broke, lonely, overwhelmed. Don't believe those lies. He wouldn't be telling you that if he didn't know you were headed to Gennesaret. You wouldn't be in that storm if you weren't headed to something greater. You're gonna come out to an abundant place, great favor, great health, great resources, not just blessed, but an abundance of blessings. Something you could have never seen without being forced into the boat, leaving the comfortable place, going through the storm. The psalmist said, we went through the fire, through the flood, to a place of great abundance. You won't see the great abundance without going through some fires, through some floods, through some storms. It's tempting to get discouraged. Men said to me last week, Joel, I was loyal to my company. For over 30 years, I gave them my best, but they weren't loyal to me. When times got tough, they let me go. That's not a surprise to God. That's a sign that He's up to something. You got pushed out into the boat. Looks like your boss is in control. The truth is, he's a pawn in the hands of God. Nothing happens without God's permission. But it takes maturity to not get bitter. And why'd they treat me badly? Why'd I come down with this illness? Why did I lose that contract? What if you knew that had to happen so you could get to Gennesaret, a place of abundance? That the storm wasn't random, it was necessary. That the trouble was transportation. That it was moving you into the fullness of what God has in store. And sure, you may go through the fire, through the flood, through the famine, but there's one more F that's coming, and that's favor. The favor of God is going to defeat enemies you couldn't defeat. The favor of God is going to open doors you couldn't open. The favor of God is going to cause you to come through the storm to a place of great abundance. My friend, Coach Tony Dungy, played professional football for many years. And after a successful career, in 1996, he landed his first job as a head coach with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And he knew it was the hand of God opening the door, a dream come true. For 6 years, everything was going great. They were winning more games, and making more progress, and he was feeling good about the future. Out of nowhere, he was let go. They fired him. He thought, God, I know you gave me this job. I know you opened this door, and I was doing my best. I don't understand why this happened. But God never closes a door unless He's going to open a bigger and better door. It may not make sense at the time. We can't see what God's up to. This is when you have to trust Him. Like the disciples, we think, God, we don't want to get in the boat and cross the lake. We want to stay here where you blessed us. What God has in store is something greater than what you have in mind. You may have seen a blessing, but He's taken you to Gennesaret, a place of abundant blessings. And of course, Coach Dungy was disappointed, but he didn't go around discouraged, sour. He knew the same God that opened the door closed the door. The scripture talks about how God is our doorkeeper. He's in control of the doors in our life. We celebrate when He opens doors and brings opportunity. But in order to move us into something greater, sometimes He has to close a door. If you don't realize that God is your doorkeeper, if you don't trust Him with your open and closed doors, then you'll be frustrated when plans don't work out, upset when He tells you to get in the boat, or bitter over that person that walked away. I used to just thank God for my open doors, but now I've learned to thank Him for my closed door. God closing a door is not only protecting you, but it's setting you up for something greater.
Not long after Coach Dungy was let go, he received a phone call from the Indianapolis Colts football team asking if he'd be interested in their head coaching job. He got the position, and 3 years later, they won the Super Bowl. He told me, if I had not gotten fired, I would have never won it. What you could be upset about, the door that closed, the person that did you wrong, the trouble in your family, it's a setup. God wouldn't have allowed it if it wasn't taking you to a new level of your destiny. That storm is blowing you from a place of blessing to an abundance of blessings. The disciples were excited over Jesus multiplying the food, that one miracle, but the storm took them to where they saw many miracles. Don't fight the closed doors, the delays, the detours. The storm feels like it's taking you to Bethsaida, a barren place, a dry place, a lonely place, but God controls the winds. You can't see it right now, but they're blowing you to an abundant place, a land of healing, a land of miracles, a land of favor. I worked 17 years behind the scenes here at Lakewood doing the television production, and I was blessed. Beautiful wife, two beautiful children, got to work with my father every day. We were the best of friends, traveled the world together. Life was good. Then my father unexpectedly went to be with the Lord. 77 years old, died from a heart attack. I didn't see that coming. Suddenly, I found myself in a storm. Like the disciples, I didn't choose to get on this boat. I was forced on it. Sometimes God will close a door and you don't have a choice. I was comfortable where I was. I didn't want to get up in front of people. I didn't know that this was in me. I thought I'd do television production the rest of my life. I was satisfied, but God knows what He put in you. There are gifts and talents that you haven't discovered yet, potential that's lying dormant. The scripture says, as an eagle stirs the nest and gets the baby eaglets out, at times God will stir your nest to get you out of a comfortable place. A place where you're familiar, where you don't have to stretch and believe and take steps of faith. It's not going to let you get stagnant. I thought losing my father would be the darkest time of my life. And yes, I missed my father, but it was that difficulty that launched me into the brightest time of my life, into what I'm doing now. My father was still here, I wouldn't be up here. Sometimes God has to push us into our purpose. But I thought that storm would take me to Bethsaida, to a barren place, discouraged. Oh man, my father's gone. But God directed the winds of that storm. They blew me to Gennesaret, a place of abundance, and favor, and opportunity, and influence. This would have never happened if I'd stayed on the shore, in the comfortable place, rejoicing over the multiplied food. That's good, but that's just a season. Where God is taking you, you're going to have to get in the boat and cross to the other side. Yes, there will be winds and waves, thoughts telling you you're not going to make it. It'll never be like it used to. Losing that loved one, it's all downhill from here. No, you're not going to Bethsaida. There's been a change in your itinerary. You can't see it yet, but you're headed to Gennesaret. Those winds you thought would stop you, they're going to blow you to a place of abundance where you see beauty for ashes, talent coming out that you didn't know you had, influence, opportunity, favor. And sure, at times it feels like the winds are too strong, the loss too painful, the sickness too great, a child that's breaking your heart. You don't think you can make it. God is saying to you what He said to them, I'm right here with you in this storm. It's going to be okay. You can relax. You're in good hands. God is in control of the winds of that storm. Those winds blew Coach Dungy from being fired to winning the Super Bowl. They blew me from behind the scenes, quiet and reserved, to speaking in front of people all over the world. They blew the disciples from celebrating one miracle to seeing an abundance of miracles. You don't know where those winds are blowing you. The enemy will whisper, man, you're going to Bethsaida, a barren place. You'll never meet the right person. never get well, never see your business blessed. Look what all you've been through. Just say, no thanks. I've had a change in my destination. There's been a route update. We're no longer going to Bethsaida. Our new arrival is Gennesaret, a place of abundance, a place of victory. Someone walked out of your life, broke your heart. The good news is, in Gennesaret, someone awesome is already waiting for you. God has already lined up your divine connections. Or you lost that loved one. That's painful, but when you get to Gennesaret, there are new beginnings. There are doors that are going to open, fresh vision. That sickness, the depression, seems like it's going to hinder you your whole life. You've been in this storm for a long time, struggling, wondering how it's going to work out. Your time is coming. That's not how your story ends. The storm looks like it's going to stop you, but God is shifting the winds. No more Bethsaida. No more that barren place. You're about to come into victory, to abundance, to joy unspeakable, to favor that you've never seen. You're going to come out of that storm and say like me, look what the Lord has done. Who would have ever thought I would be where I am? I believe even now, dreams are coming back to life. Hope is rising. You're going to feel a fresh wind in your spirit. That's the Most High God breathing on your life. But a key to all of this is trusting when you don't understand. We prayed for God to heal my father just as much as we did to heal my mother. She's still here at 90 years young, but my father didn't get healed that way. This is when you have to say, God, I trust your ways. I may not like it, but I know you're good. I know you're for me. And you wouldn't have allowed it if it was going to stop my destiny. In the book of Acts, the disciples were seeing great favor in the upper room. The Holy Spirit came like a rushing mighty wind. They were all filled with the Spirit. They went throughout Jerusalem praying for people. The sick were healed. The lame walked. They spoke to great crowds and many people became believers. It's an amazing time of blessing and favor. But in Acts chapter 8, it says, a great wave of persecution arose, and all the disciples fled to Jerusalem, from Jerusalem to Judea and Samaria. Doesn't say they decided to leave. They all agreed it was a good time to go somewhere else. They didn't have a choice. They were forced out. The opposition was so strong, they had to flee for their lives. Saul and his group had already killed Stephen. Now they were looking for the other believers. It's significant that God could have stopped the persecution. He could have shut down Saul. God parted the Red Sea. He shut the mouths of hungry lions. He protected teenagers in a fiery furnace. But sometimes God is using the storm as transportation to move you to a new level of your destiny. I'm sure some of them thought, God, what did we do wrong? We felt the rushing mighty wind. We saw the tongues of fire, but now we're on the run. They felt forsaken, like they'd been forgotten. But if God is closing a door, if he's allowing you to be pushed out, that means he's up to something. Trust him in the trouble. Don't fight the winds of the storm. You can't override what God has purposed. Let those winds blow you to where God is taking you. The disciples didn't like this storm, but it was a setup. They were forced out of Jerusalem, so they went to Judea and Samaria and began to share their faith. Had they not left Jerusalem, Christianity wouldn't have spread. They would have just kept it to the Jewish people. God had to get them out of their nest. They were satisfied in Jerusalem, but what God had in mind was much bigger. Because of that storm, that opposition, you and I are people of faith today. We're believers because they got pushed out and it spread all over the world. You don't know what God is up to. In real time, we can't see it. All we know is we're in a storm that we didn't choose. Persecution pushed us out. A friend walked away. The medical report hasn't improved. God is saying, I'm still in control. I'm still ordering your steps. It's all going to turn out fine for you. Everything is serving his plan. Now trust him when you don't understand. Trust him when it doesn't make sense. Thoughts will whisper, you're going to Bethsaida, a barren place. It's always going to be a struggle. You'll always have to deal with this sickness, always be lonely. No, what you can't see right now are those winds are blowing you to Gennesaret, to a garden of abundance, to a bountiful place, a healthy place, a victorious place. God didn't bring you this far to leave you where you are. Get your fire back. Get your passion back. The best part of your life is still in front of you. That loss didn't stop your destiny. What looks like your darkest hour, like God did for me, it's going to launch you into your brightest hour. The people that walked away, they didn't stop your purpose. They had to leave so you could meet someone better, a divine connection. That door that closed, you got pushed out of Jerusalem. It had to close so you could step into greater things. The storm feels like a setback, but really it's a setup. God is working behind the scenes, getting you in position to go places you've never dreamed. You haven't seen, heard, or imagined what God has in store for you. Now trust his ways. If you'll do this, I believe and declare those winds that should have defeated you, God is shifting them right now. They're about to blow you into favor, healing, breakthroughs, new levels. You're going to come into an abundant place, an abundance of health, an abundance of joy, an abundance of resources, the fullness of your destiny in Jesus' name. And if you receive it, can you say amen? Let's pray together. I receive it for myself as well. Lord, I thank you for what we've heard today. I know it falls on great ground, faithful people here at Lakewood and so many watching and listening. And Lord, I thank you we're going out of here with a greater trust in you. Lord, we're going to quit worrying and being upset and stressed over what didn't work out. Lord, we trust you as our doorkeeper. Lord, we believe that you're in control, working all things for our good. And Lord, I just speak your blessings over your people today. With our heads bowed in prayer, just an important question before we leave. If your heart stopped beating in the next few minutes, are you at peace with God? Do you know where you'd spend eternity if you died a little while from now? If not, I would love to pray with you. I'm not here to condemn anybody. I'm here to help you find a new beginning. I know this comes from a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. In just a moment, if you're not at peace with the Lord, or maybe you are a Christian, but you've grown cold toward God, you know you need to recommit your life. You need a fresh new start. If that's you, in just a moment, I'm going to ask you to take a step of faith and stand right where you are, and we'll pray together. I can't think of a better time to get on the road to victory than right now. God is not mad at you. Your sins have already been forgiven. All you have to do is accept the free gift of Christ's salvation. Will you do it today? The enemy in your thoughts will whisper, do it next week. Do it another time. Listen, the Bible says, today is the day of salvation. Don't put it off. It's so easy. Well, Joel, it's embarrassing to stand in front of everyone. Have people at the house. I can't lift my hand. Listen to what Jesus said. If you won't be ashamed of me before people, then I won't be ashamed of you before my Father in heaven. I'm going to give you a great opportunity to show God that you're not ashamed of him. If you're not at peace with the Lord, or you just need to rededicate your life, you need a fresh new start, a new beginning. If that's you, would you be bold, take that step of faith and stand right where you are and we'll pray together. Would you do that? Come on, Lakewood, let's give them a hand as they stand all over the building. Come on, don't put it off. I feel like there ought to be others. Anybody else? Your heart's beating fast. That's God drawing you. Anybody else? Up top, watching, listening. Still time for you. Anybody else? Well, God bless you. Please remain standing if you don't mind. Let me tell you how proud we are of you. More importantly, I know the angels are rejoicing in the heavens right now. God's never going to be ashamed of you because you took this step of faith. The scripture says that whoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Let me help you to call. Do you mind all praying this after me? Lord Jesus, I repent of my sins. Come into my heart. I make you my Lord and Savior. Amen. Remain standing one more moment if you don't mind. Let me tell you how much we love you, how proud we are of you. We're going to be praying for you. And also want to give you a personal invitation and a challenge to come back and be with us on a regular basis. We ask new believers, give us the next year of your life. Make a commitment, just like you go to work, that it's going to be a priority. You're going to be here in person, online, on the radio, however you do it. I'll make a promise. Before that year is over, your life is never going to be the same for the better. We're going to help you grow and become who God's created you to be. I think I said it earlier, but I know Sundays you're busy, you work hard, it's probably a day off. You think, man, I just want to relax. But let me tell you, there is a blessing on your life when you put God first, when you get into a community of faith. I hope you'll take me up on that. We'd love to have you here, but at least go somewhere. But hey, after service, there's a room over here called New Beginnings. If you need anything, check it out. There's a New Beginnings class online. There's other classes after the service if you'd like to go to. But know this, the moment you stood up, God washed away all your sins, your mistakes, your failures. You are starting with a fresh, clean slate. Write it down in your Bible, April 14th, 2024, a new day of victory in your life. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, let's all stand together if you would, please. Thanks so much for coming out today. How many of you are going home better off than you were before? Amen. We love you guys. I'm going to speak a blessing. Until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord show you His favor and have mercy on you. And may the Lord watch over you and give you His peace. God bless you. Have a great week, a favor-filled week. And we'll see you back sometime real soon.
Wow, Lakewood family, what amazing and powerful message today from our pastor, Pastor Joel. And it was just encouraging and refreshing to know that sometimes when we go through difficult moments in our life, if it's a closed door or if you're dealing with a bad situation, it's amazing when you can just know that God is in control. Pastor Joel mentioned trusting God when you don't understand, and that sometimes trouble can be your transportation to get you to where you're going. And so you might find yourself in a situation right now, and it's like, man, there's a closed door, or you're dealing with a situation in your finances, or you're struggling within your career, or a relationship has ended, or you know, you're not being treated right at work. Whatever the case might be, God can be utilizing this situation to take you to another level in your life. Our God is in control of everything. And so I just want to encourage you, we are continuing to pray for you here at Lakewood Church. Thank you for being a part of our services. And we know that God is going to continue to do some great things in your life. Also, I would love to give a big shout out to our Sirius XM radio listeners and those that are watching online on YouTube. Feel free to share our today's message with Pastor Joel by sharing the message. You are sharing the gospel to individuals that we maybe cannot reach. And so we want to thank you for continuing to support our ministry here at Lakewood Church. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, my friends, that is the singular most powerful decision that you and I will ever make. And so feel free to let us know. Type new into the chat, and we want to continue to pray for you, and we're believing that. Also, if you're online and you accepted Christ for the first time, type new to 77377, and we would love to continue to give you resources that will help you along your walk with Christ. Great opportunities. We're believing that God is going to catapult you to another level of influence, and that there's a reason why you are tuned in right now. And we're believing and declaring that the best is still yet to come. Also, next week, please stop by or tune in next week. Pastor Lisa will be here to share another powerful message, and we hope that you could tune in next week to be a part of our services. And again, what a great service from Pastor Joel, and we're so grateful. Know that your family here at Lakewood, we love you. We're continuing to pray for you, and we're expecting a great week. May God bless you, and we look forward to seeing you soon. Take care, and God bless.